three letters, three logo ideas that are going to get your juices going and you start creating amazing looking logos. This is our first logo design we're going to do together, and we're going to convert this one to 3D. This is our second, much more subtle, simple, but sophisticated logo that we've designed. And this is the last one using effects on Canva. Let's jump in and do this. To start our three-letter, three-logo idea video, we're going to access canva.com and we're going to create a blank logo canvas. After you've opened your logo canvas, you're going to press T for text to add your text. We're going to make the size of this, let's make it 140. We're going to start adding your letter. We're going to use RTH as the three-letter logo. This is from one of our community members, Ravi, who's in India. Ravi, we hope you're good and you are hanging on there. And we're going to find this font. We're going to use Sinzao font, this gorgeous font that we're going to be using. And we're going to duplicate that and create a T, duplicate that and create an H so that you have a nice RTH. You're going to align it. Next, you're going to go to your styles, and I want the system to pick styles that are quite nice for the brand that we're creating for. We found this one, but if you scroll down and you go to color palette and you click on see all, you get to have the color palettes that have been put together by the Canva designers. So this is quite gorgeous, and this is what we're going to be running with. Next, we're going to press L for line. We go to styles and we pick our color and we zoom in and we rotate this to 90 degrees so that it is a straight line. We move it next to the R. We zoom in again and then we align it. And then we make the line weight bigger so that it's like 18, and then it fills the R like that. So we need to just make it like that, so that it is completely aligned. We're gonna duplicate our line, move it to the H like that. And then we're gonna bring our T a little bit on top and we duplicate the line. Next thing you're gonna do, you're gonna duplicate your shape and then rotate the shape. And then press T for text to add your tagline on your little box. If you're patient and slow, it can all be worth. We can always space our letters so that it is nicely fitted in there and it looks absolutely stunning and gorgeous. And that takes care of your first logo. We're gonna add a second page and then we're going to create the second logo. Oh, I had fun with this one. We're gonna press T for text. We're gonna change our font and we're gonna look for that Canva Sans medium font and we're gonna use that for our design. We're gonna enlarge, gonna just make it a little bit more large, maybe 140. Next, we're going to press L for line and we're going to rotate our line to 90 degrees so that it is perfectly still. Then we're going to add the line just below the R and we're going to create a little box over there. So I'm going to move that and then I'm going to increase the weight of the line. 21, 21 works. So with your line, you're gonna duplicate that, rotate it. Next, we're gonna go and look for a leaf that we're gonna add for growth on our design. The last thing that I would do is to press C for circle to add a circle on my tree like that. And then I wanna go back to our design and go to style so that I can use the same color palette and have that gorgeous looking logo design that I'm almost done. So we're gonna press T for text as
we want to add the last tagline. Beautiful. Group it, size it, align it. Number two, beautifully done. This one I love. Let me know if I'm adding value. Add on the comments below. Smash that like button if this is exciting you. Let's jump in on the last one. The last one, we're going to press T for text. And we're going to use a Fridoka font. It's called Fridoka 1. And we're going to create a RTH logo. And we're going to create the last page. We're going to add the tagline on a separate page. I'm going to download the letters and download the tagline separately and then re-upload them on Canva so that I can use the effect and have this design that I have in my mind. Hopefully it's going to work out the way that it is in my mind. So we're going to download page 3 as transparent background, and we're going to download page 4 for the tagline as transparent background. Next, you're going to upload the tagline as well as the logo, the characters of the logo, to your upload files and then add it to your design. So we're going to start with the characters. We're going to just reduce the extra sizing and then make it larger. And then we're gonna go and apply the effect that we would love to have. So you're gonna select the image and you're gonna go to edit image and you're gonna select shadows. If you don't see shadows on your, if you haven't used it recently like I have, scroll down until you find the shadows. There's different kinds of shadows. You're going to go with glow and you're gonna select glow. And the software is going to allow you to choose settings, and then you can make the different glow of your design the way that you want. So we're going to change the color of the glow, and we're going to make that light blue. And we're going to completely switch off the blur, and then we're going to increase the transparency like that. You could also increase the size. We make the size 10, and we're going to do exactly the same with our social media growth. And that takes care of our three logos. So you must let me know in the comments below which one is your favorite, number 1, 2, or 3. And we're going to download number 2, because number 2 is my favorite. But you can download whichever one that you decide, and then you're going to jump into Photopea and convert it to a 3D logo. I absolutely love this logo. So I'm going to go with number 2, and I'm going to go download it as a transparent background. Again, if you don't have Canva Pro, use erase.bg or use remove.bg to download it as a transparent background. Then you're going to jump in on Photopea. Once we get here, we're going to select PSD templates, and we're going to pick any one of these templates to convert it to a 3D. And we're going to go to our mockups, and we love the office room. Let's use the office room, thanks to our buddies at graphicsfamily.com. And we're going to click on photopea.com and open the mockup. Once the mockup is open, you're going to double click on the checkered box where it says your logo here. And then you see how it's going to look like and how you should be placing your 2D logo. Then you hide clicking the eye, and then you click and you drag your 2D logo, and then you size it and make it nice and big. Once that's done, you're going to go Command S or Control S to change it to Smart Object. And then we are going to click back on the first tab to have our gorgeous looking 3D logo created. I absolutely love this one. We're going to go File, Export as a PNG. You can export by clicking on Save. If you enjoy these kinds of tutorials, you're just going to love this AE logo that we did in gold. Go watch it on this next video. Thank you for joining me on this tutorial. I will see you on the next video.